Good morning from Twin Oaks. Hey, it's Melissa. I'm out here in the Meat Bird chicken pen. We're checking things out. We are adjusting for the weather, which you're always adjusting with meat chickens. The Meat Bird you just saw, he's 5 weeks old. And we grow them out over 6 weeks. So this flock is really close to going to the processor. So I wanted to show you in the chicken pen today some of what we work around with temperatures when you're raising meat birds. Because if you're raising meat birds, one of the tips that we would give you is to really be proactive about making them as comfortable as possible with the temperature, really trying to work with controlling the temperature. So I wanted to show you what's going on now, because 2 days ago, so we're in February in southeastern Ohio, and 2 days ago it was 70 degrees. So this pen that these birds are in is probably, this pen's probably about 13 foot by 14 foot size, and right now there's 79 birds in it, and that's about the max that this pen will hold. But when it was 70 degrees, this pen was getting too warm. The pen was 68 degrees, but the birds were too hot. So there's a lot of dynamics that go on with the temperature for your birds, because for one thing, you always have to bear in mind, you know, they're at floor level. So it matters what the temperature is down here where these birds are living. That is where their comfort zone is determined. And so you've got that going on. The other thing that's going on is, you know, the flooring. So there's no way around it. It's bedding, and there's chicken manure in it. And so as that builds up and they compact it, that produces a lot of heat in the pen as well. So we love that as a deep litter bedding method when it's cold, but when it gets warm outside and it's like 70 degrees and you need to cool the birds down, that floor heat is gonna work against you if it's coming, you know, from that deep litter bedding and you can't cool it down. So, so obviously, you know, one temperature thing for the birds' internal temperature is keep waters filled. But you really have to work at controlling the pen. So, of course, that's why we have all these heat lamps. And yesterday, so 2 days ago was 70 degrees. Yesterday was about 56, and it was still about 70 degrees in the pen here. So when it was 70, we actually had to move the birds out of the pen. And we did a YouTube video that day, so you might have seen them. In the meat birds, they were outside in the front yard because we had to cool them down. They were actually overheating inside this pen. Then yesterday, we were able to leave them inside, but what we did, one of our mitigation measures for temperature is this panel of the wall here. So this building is metal on the outside and wood on the inside with a little bit of a dead air space in between, and there's, you can see up top, there's ventilation up at the top. So one of the mitigation measures for us when it's real hot is we can take this panel off in this building, and there's chicken wire to protect from predators. So we did that, and that made it work out yesterday. We were able to have that off and their door open with we put a protective screen outside to keep predators out and keep them relatively close to the barn. So that mitigated temperature yesterday. So then it was well into the 50 degree marks overnight up to about midnight. This morning it's 37. And so I'll show you what I've got going, like back here. I'm gonna work on this next. These birds hanging out in this corner, they're piling up like that because they're getting cold. They're chilled. We're seeing a little bit of that. I'll show you again back in this opposite corner. They're getting chilled as well. So we are going to actually put that panel back on to try to control that temperature. So it is, because it's getting down, it's like 38 in the pen. So where they're getting under the heat lamps, you know, we're seeing that here too. They're crowding under the heat lamps. And if you're raising meat birds, their behavior will tell you if they're comfortable or not comfortable. So I wanted to show you that about temperature. We're gonna keep working on keeping their temperature of their environment comfortable as we finish them. And they've got about 5 days left here before we take them to the processor. But our ideal temperature range would be if we could keep our birds' environment and floor at 68 degrees. It's hard to do when you don't have heated barns, and when you have small flocks and you're not investing in heated barns, you work with the other tools and means that you have. So anyway, we'll be excited to see you again soon, joining us in another YouTube video. Please press subscribe while you're watching. It helps us out a ton. We have a lot of great local folks who are supporting us, and we really appreciate that. Thank you, Beverly Feed and Equipment, and all the individuals for sharing about our YouTube channel, Twin Oaks Farm Poultry. And please subscribe if you're watching and check out our other videos. But we'll do a couple series coming up. One, the good, the bad, and the ugly of raising meat birds. And another one, we're going to actually follow, our next flock comes here in about a week, and we're going to actually follow them week by week with updates in YouTube videos. So you'll get to see a flock from start to finish, or as we say, hatch to harvest, and see how that goes for them. So thanks for joining. I'm going to give a last look at the birds, and then we're going to see you next time. Have a great day. God bless you.